I'm gonna make you an offer you can't refuse. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna make you an offer you can't refuse.
What is up, guys? My name is Chubby Moo. Boom, back in 2012, I talked about that game, Mafia 2. I've only completed like 5 games in the last couple years, and Mafia 2 is one of them. The Call of Duty campaigns, The Last of Us, Metro 2033. But Mafia 2, there was something about it that was pretty rad, right? Like, you have GTA, you have all those other games, but when it came to Mafia 2, I was just hooked, and it was one of those games that I sat down, and over 2 days, I finished it, and I had tweeted Tony Pizza Guy, because we were kind of, I think we were sick of playing WWE at the time, so I tried to play other stuff, and I was like, damn, I miss gaming, dude. I miss just having fun. So, before we even get into this video, guys, I want to know, besides WWE, what games do you love? What games inspire you? Like, you know, I've got a green screen back there, I've got all this other stuff, but like, I don't ever get the chance to play tons of games because I'm always playing WWE. So I want to know, what are your favorite games besides WWE? Do you have any interest in games besides WWE? And if so, what console are you playing on? So on PS4, which I'm so excited about, right? We're talking about Mafia 2. Boom! Mafia 3! I'm not getting paid for this. I just legitimately love Mafia. So I want to get in and play it. Hopefully you guys enjoy it, man, because
I'm going to make you an offer you can't refuse. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make you an offer you can't refuse.
Anyway, like I said, I just love gaming. So we're going to play some Mafia 3. Mafia 3. Let's go.
A modern city with traditional southern values.
I underestimated how far he was going to go. What he was willing to do.
Visit the historic French Ward and enjoy local cuisine at one of our 5-star restaurants.
Killing them wasn't enough. Lincoln Clay was using them to send a message.
Or spend the afternoon in the bayou and take in its natural splendor.
Sal Marcano had no idea what he was going to unleash.
New Bordeaux. Safe. Family-oriented fun. Make it your next vacation destination.
This city survived the War of 1812, the Civil War, and God knows how many hurricanes. But when Lincoln Clay went after the mob, he inflicted more damage than all the wars and hurricanes combined.
Lincoln's mother abandoned him in 1947, a couple of years after he was born. His mother, I heard she was Dominican. I always figured his father was white, maybe even Italian. Not that it mattered. Back then, if you look black, you black. Same as today, I suppose. He stayed at the orphanage until 1958.
Now, when did you meet Lincoln Clay?
1966. I was running black ops out of Laos on behalf of the CIA. He was loaned out to me via joint CIA-DOD task force.
He was a quiet boy. Good boy.
2 Purple Hearts, a Bronze Star, and the Distinguished Service Cross. He served his country with honor and distinction.
After the city closed the orphanage, he fell in with Sammy Robinson. Sammy ran the black mob over in Delray Hollow. I can't say I approved, but often colored boys didn't have a lot of options back then. Boys like Lincoln, ones who've been abandoned, they're always looking for a home, always looking for a place to belong. I think he thought he'd find it in the army. Thing is, once that's lost,
never get it back again. When he returned from the war, Lincoln ended back up over at Sammy's. Now Sammy owed the Italian mob a whole lot of money, and he needed Lincoln's help. It's a damn shame what happened. It breaks my heart.
Still say this is the craziest goddamn thing I ever heard. Using real money to rob the feds.
Well, hell, man, not like this is our cash. This all came from Skeletta. Besides, peanuts compared to what we're gonna haul out of there.
Is everything we need to burn?
Yeah, that's it. I grab the keys to the truck, then we can get the fuck out of here. Keys are in the other room. Grab them so we can get the hell out of here.
All right. I'm so excited, man. Mafia 2 is one of, like, the only games I actually completed, so... I've completed, like, 5 games in the past couple years being a full-time WWE YouTuber. Because, you know, you really don't play stuff if you're not gonna record it.
Still not sure about leaving him like this.
He came through with the truck just like we asked. Even greased his partner to make it look good. If you got doubts, why take the chance?
Apparently. All right, what do we got? Go ahead and search the... Wait, I can go, like, take the body somewhere?
You got the keys, so you can drive.
I didn't mean to do that.
Let's get the hell out of here.
Alright, let's get the hell out of here. Where do I go? Is there, like, a door? Oh, duh. Toby, you want to walk around to go to the door, bro? Not a very smart cookie.
Let's go, man. The clock's
okay, I'm going, dude. Let me run. It's so weird not using the triangle button to run. No. Okay, it started. I didn't think it would start for a second. Alright.
Take it easy heading to town. We don't need the cops crawling up our asses.
Alright, man. Alright, so looks like we got a long drive ahead of us.
Back there. He ain't got no idea what he's in for.
What was his cut? 5%?
Actually, let's make sure that the game sounds... Yeah, all right. We're gonna keep the music all the way down there.
I like he'll be able to spend it. Feds will be watching his every move for the rest of his life. Probably better we just whacked him.
If I learned anything in Nam, always a good idea to dangle someone out there.
Let's not crash, dude.
And you just slip away.
So answer me this: what's the craziest thing you saw over there?
You don't want to know.
Hell, man, I'm a taxpayer. I got the right to know how my money's being spent.
Oh, Georgie Marcano pays taxes.
Damn right I do. That's how they got Al Capone, and I ain't going to prison for no fucking tax bill. Huh. So come on, you going to answer the question or what?
Yeah. Oh, the driving is actually kind of sweet, dude.
We on the coast of Quang Nai.
Felt like I was drifting a little bit right there.
Evacuating the civvies for Charlie overran everything. Anyway, we get
into oh, shit! No.
This woman walks
okay.
Up. She got a baby.
We don't want the cops
head,
on her ass, and I'm driving like that.
She starts up the ramp, and the MP stops her, tells her, you can only bring one thing on board. So she tosses the baby in the
car. Am I driving on a train track? No, MP get off the train track, dude.
Tell someone dive in after the kid, start screaming at the woman,
okay,
wants to know what
we
the
probably
fuck
don't
she's want thinking.
To be driving on a train
you know
track.
What she says, dude? She says, I can always have another baby.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Okay, we went the wrong way.
Hey, man, you asked.
Yeah, but I thought you were going to tell me a story about some gook getting his dick blown off or something. I mean, god damn.
Yeah, we went the wrong way.
Not like you think. Conditions over there, man. Jesus Christ. One day you're raising cattle, tending your rice. Next day everything bombed flat. You put people up against the wall, they will do anything to survive.
That better have been one delicious fucking pig.
All right, so we got to drive all the way over there. We're about... Oh, that was just 1337, dude. That was Lee. Where's the bridge? All right, so the bridge is up... Oh, wow. I should pay attention. I was looking ahead. All right, so we got to get up on this bridge. How do I get around there to go up? Is there like a... Oh, there it is. Okay. So we're going to fly across this bridge quick, and we're going to drive across. I have to say, the game is looking really good, man. It feels really good. It's playing pretty well. Yeah, I don't want to shoot anybody. No, put that away. Get off the horn, dude. Oh, he's got the gun just ready to go. Now, you can put that back in your pocket, man. I'm not going to use the gun. Oh, no. We don't want to get cops on us, dude. Don't fire your gun. Let's not be stupid, dude. All right. Get out of my way. Oh, that's a red light. So we already wasted a bullet, man. Hopefully we don't get in a big combat and only lose by one bullet. We got some speed going now. Look at us. We're catching up. All right, we got to hit the brakes.
Guys at the reserve probably won't be too keen on you waltzing around with that piece of yours.
That's one of the most realistic breakings in a game I think I've felt. I don't know what other people are going to think, but when I stopped there, like, you legitimately kept sliding through a little bit.
Time to see if these forged IDs are worth a fuck. All
right, so let's pull in. And here we go. Let's see if those forged IDs are worth a fuck.
Back it up to the loading dock.
Yeah, we got in. That's what's up.
Some of these fellas might get a little rough with the language, and...
Well, I ain't like I never been called nigger before.
Nah, I know, but I'm just saying, if I go along with it, ain't nothing personal.
The only thing I care about is getting our hands on that money.
That's all I care about too, man.
When I say something about being hot, that's when we make our move.
All right. All
right, man. I got you.
Right, here we go.
Put your IDs up the glass.
We're part of the Boeing crew.
The fuck's this shitheel doing here?
Affirmative action. You know how it is.
Old country is spinning around a goddamn toilet.
Damn, dude. So I get why they included it in the game, though.
As for you, go on and grab those bags off the truck. You'll be carrying them to the burning room. How much y'all bring in?
$238,546. Small bills, mostly.
I'll have Miss Gale call up your office when we're done. She'll confirm the delivery.
Appreciate it.
All right, so let's take the money. We got to follow the guard. All right, what's that guy working on? You're working on a clock radio?
You need to check that scatter gun. You packing anything?
Still in training.
Good. One less goddamn thing for me to worry about.
You can pick it up on the way out.
Yeah, man, it's all good. Just let me in.
Buying
room's I'm good.
Down in the cellar. This way.
All right.
I ain't seen y'all around these parts before.
Y'all's over in Georgia for a while. He just got out the service.
And my cousin's been trying to get on here for over a year now. Yeah. Was in the Navy for two tours, got medals falling out of his ass. Government tells him thanks, but no thanks.
That's a crock of shit if I ever heard one.
Sad day when a God-fearing white man can't get a job, but ain't your nigga who staggers in his hide on the spot.
Right. So, am I going to have to make two trips to get the other bags? Because there was a bunch of other bags. And like,
You bastards better not be playing with each other back there.
Yeah, don't be playing with each other.
Fuck you! Gosh, look at that. Didn't know y'all held that much gold.
Yeah, Washington's been shuffling around on account of the war. It's here, then it gets sent to Dallas, then it comes back. Yeah, it doesn't make a lick of goddamn sense.
Alright, wait, are there guns in the bag? Is that what we're about to pull out right now?
Yeah, we are.
Alright. Are we about to burn two?
Put those bags on the table there.
I don't want to burn the money, dude.
Never done this detail before. Figured it'd be bigger.
It gets the job done. Only time there's a problem is when the flue clogs up.
Fuck, that's some heat right there.
Used to use coal for it, but a year or so back we switched over to oil. Maintains a more consistent flame.
Here's some guy come around the house trying to switch me over to oil. Told him I wasn't interested.
I never was neither till I saw this.
All right, we gotta wait. Is he gonna call me out?
We don't get soot all over the goddamn place. Used to be we'd have a nigga come in.
Oh, because he said heat wave before that.
God, that guy was an asshole.
We need to move. Danny and Ellis should be coming up any time now.
All right, give me a second.
All right, where are we gonna put him now?
All right, you take care of those guards. Keep your ass down. You don't want them getting a drop on us.
I know what the fuck.
I gotta
I'm
drop
doing.
Him, dude. Drop him. No, come on, drop him. Oh, duh, the bottom arrow. Toby, do you want to look and pay attention? Let's hide behind all the money. Are you ready to go? Hey, bro, you want to come in here? All right, we're going to make our move.
You know that house we've been renting out?
Yeah.
Called over there last night. Told them I wanted to sell it. Told them
to be out. Oh,
And the guy, his name's John. Starts laying into me. Saying the lease gives them the right to a 30-day notice. That's how we're supposed to find a new place in 2 weeks. So I tell him none of that's my goddamn
There we
property.
Go, we hide him.
It's my property, and I'll do with it what I please. And if it brings up that fucking lease again, I'll use it to wipe my ass and make him eat it. Not only that, I know he's friends with a couple of niggas, and they go over there at night and play cards. Told John when they moved in that I wouldn't tolerate niggas on my property. Neighbors see that, they start questioning me, wanting to know the kind of people I associate with. Let the niggas play cards with other niggas, I say. Fucking assholes.
Bam! Sorry, bro. Grab the AK-47, dude. I'll go hide the body.
Come on, we need to get this vault open.
Yeah, we need to get the vault open, but I just want to hide the guards in case. Maybe you don't have to do this. Maybe this is pointless. But I feel like when in a stealthy game, there's probably... I don't even consider this necessarily stealthy, but...
Come on, we need to get this vault
open.
We
do, but I want to... All right, weapons menu, L1. All right. Open this vault.
Oh, I hope this domination skeletor got us. Is that legit?
Is it legit? And... Is it? Oh my God, it's legit.
Well, I'll be damned. All right, go for it, Godzilla.
There we go.
Holy fucking shit.
It's beautiful. All right, I'm gonna take care of this room. You see what you can get from outside. Once these boys punch you with that drill, we're gonna start throwing this down.
Triggered the fucking alarm?
Shit, I didn't notice this cage was on a different system. All right,
We're gonna hold off the guards until Danny's done drilling. Hey, you're gonna pull this off.
All right, I'm trusting you. All right, here we go. Looking for cover. Boom, baby. Oh, headshot. Take your head out, bro. Did I take him out? No, no, no. Get rid of the body. I just want to... How do I actually, like, loot him? Or can I loot him? Or is it just automatic? Wow, I'm not even paying attention. Where are they shooting from? Yeah, no, I'm fine with low aim.
Out of here is if we get the weapons stored in that armory. Bust the door open. I'll watch our asses.
I got it, dude.
My old man gonna shit a brick when he hears about this.
You keep doing that. I'm trying to find more weapons, bro. Alright, let's run back over here.
Give me that damn thing.
Get out of my way, dude. I'm a powerhouse. Oh shit, are we getting... Is that a Browning? Alright, expose the lock, rotate into the green zone, and then press. It's like I'm on a ladder. Alright. There we go. A Hartman. Okay, never mind. I thought it was a Brownie.
Face way worse than this over in Nam. Little smoke don't mean shit. Stay close to the vault. Watch for the drill. I'll deal with these assholes.
Yo, bro. I got you.
Well, Sammy Wait, what? Had men all over the place. Now, one of them worked at a cleaner's and stole the uniforms Georgie Marcano and Lincoln Clay wore on the day of the robbery. Another one was a janitor at the Federal Reserve, and he provided a rough layout. The robbery of the Federal Reserve was timed perfectly, and none of it would have been possible without the involvement of Sammy Robinson, Lincoln Clay, and the rest of the black mob.
And we're gonna flashback. All right.
You just come from Vietnam?
That's right.
I was a Marine in the Pacific. You take it from me. Just because you're home doesn't mean you're back. You understand? People around here, they don't get it. Never will. Keep your ass out of trouble.
Will do. Yo, that is a sick car, though, dude.
Sorry I'm late. Got caught up crossing the bridge.
Don't worry about it.
Excuse me, sir. I'm looking for my stepbrother, Lincoln Clay. You seen him? He used to get ticked off if you were even a minute late.
Kiss my ass.
There he is. How was the trip?
Is how this is the first time in 4 years and somebody telling me where to go, what to do, or how to do it. It was fucking great. What's new with the old man?
Man, don't even get me started on Pops. He used to pull his head out of his ass.
Same as ever then.
Brother, you have no fucking idea.
Damn, Ellis. She's looking good. Just like I left her.
Man, even I know not to fuck around with your cop.
All right, come on. I'm ready to go home.
so am I. Let's do this. I want to drive this bad boy. Set route options on the menu. Go to it and select it. Okay. So we want to go where we have to go. We're going to set the spot. I have to be honest, man. I am really, from what I've played so far, I'm really enjoying this, dude. Like, this is exactly what I expected out of Mafia 3 so far. Look at that, pulling out.
Sammy's doing all right.
Ever since we got your telegram about coming home, he's been climbing the walls. What if the plane crashes?
Come on, try to get those tires spinning.
What if they call him back? And he goes stand in front of the kitchen window and sip his whiskey like he was expecting you to come strolling up the sidewalk. Don't say nothing about me telling you.
Yo.
I won't.
I don't know if it's just me, but I really love these driving physics.
Ever since, mama. This ain't no man. Chill the fuck
Yeah, I'm
out.
Sorry, dude. I'm having too much fun in this car.
Was I? He'll be fine once he sees you. Ever since, mama.
Let's go, dude. Yo, whoever makes car racing games, they need to, like, talk to 2K right now. I mean, maybe it's not perfect, but there's something about the driving compared to other open-world games. The police will attack if you commit crimes, attack suspiciously, or break laws. Police awareness. Okay.
You remember Marty and Ron Langford?
Sure.
They moved up to Empire Bay a year or so after.
You're not gonna.
You
don't fuck with me, cops.
Started selling weed. They call and ask me if I want something.
Oh, shit. Okay, we're going over the bridge.
Free money as far as I'm concerned. Anyhow, a month back, Marty drops me a line and says they're moving into heroin, that they're looking for a partner down around these parts.
Can't imagine.
Whoa, let's not hit another guy, dude.
I'm talking about the weed. That ain't nothing to nobody. But this, I gotta talk to him about. I ain't said more than 3 words, and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses, and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with you. Fuck it, it's your car.
Oh, no. Let's not drive it into that.
Where was I? I ain't said more than 3 words, and he's yelling about the feds. How we don't need J. Edgar up our asses, and what the fuck am I thinking? Selling dope with kids running around the neighborhood. We ain't selling no dope to no children.
Like they got any money to...
This ain't no man. Chill the fuck out.
Okay, so he said that twice. There's nothing wrong with that.
Anyway, as I was saying, like they got any money to begin with.
I'm doing really bad at driving. It's because I'm kind of messing around a little bit. But
that was pretty serious shit. Knew a couple guys over in Nam who were running it. Wound up pissing off the wrong person. Got their throats cut.
Shit, man. I know what's what. That's why I'm talking to Georgie about it.
No way Sal's going to go along with that.
Georgie says he'd keep his old man from fighting out. We'll steer clear of the Hollow in Frisco, just sailing the French Wall. George's Uncle Lou won't say shit as long as we give him a taste of the action.
I don't know, man. George is a cool cat and all, but heroin ain't the kiddie pool.
Come in on it with us. I bet he'd agree.
I'm gonna park backwards because I'm cool like that. All right, so we finally got here. So this is Mafia 3. We're gonna go get a taste of the action and talk to Sammy. And let's be honest, man. I'm so thankful to have Mafia 3. Like I said, Mafia 2 is one of the very few games I've completed in the last couple of years because I've been playing so much WWE. Getting back to gaming for fun. We'll be back with more GTA 5. We'll be back with more Mafia 3 in the next part.